ज्ञानचारे यमुना किरणचारे जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज विहारी Radha Madhava Ju ki jai, Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Sayam Vishnu Paraparamahansa Parivaraja Kachaja. Ashto Tarashata Shishi Manhi, Divine Grace of Bhai Charanaravinda. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Iskon Patista Acharya Jagat Guru Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Jayananta Kota Vaishnabrinda ki jai. Namacharya Sri Haridastakur ki jai, Premsikho Sri Krishna, Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Garata Shiva Shari, Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Jai Sri Radha Krishna Gopopinath Shyamakunda Radha Kunda Giri Govardhana ki jai, Sri Vrindavan Dham ki jai, Navadeep Sri Mayapur Dham ki jai, Gangamai ki jai, Jamunamai ki jai, Bhakti Devi ki jai, Tulasi Maharani ki jai, Sri Hari Nam Samkitan Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Jai Nitai Go Premanandi Hari Hari Bo. All glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glory to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga, glories to Sri Prabhupada. Shrimati Radha Rani Mahotsav Titi Ki Jai, Radha Madhav Ju Ki Jai. Prabhupada said this song, Radha Madhava, is the picture of Vrindavan. Radha is there, Krishna is there, Govardhan, Jamuna, Yashoda. It's a picture of Vrindavan. So today we are celebrating the appearance day of Srimati Radharani, the internal potency of the Lord, the pleasure potency, the best of all the potencies of Krishna. Krishna likes happiness. Everybody likes happiness. It's the goal of life. Whatever anyone is doing is for happiness. That is the purpose of life. The purpose of life is happiness, pleasure, but Krishna's pleasure. But we've mistaken it to be, our purpose of life is for my pleasure. Purpose of life is for Krishna's pleasure. So she is that actual pleasure potency. She is what gives Krishna that. When Haladini potency is there, then Krishna will relate to that person or service. Because of the pleasure potency that's there. So the idea is that when we become purified by the process of devotional service, then then the Haladini potency can come. Haladini potency means the Ananda potency. We say Satchit Ananda. Shandini Shambit and Haladini. So that's the pleasure potency. So when that, when the devotees have that potency by the special mercy of Radharani and the devotees is bestowed upon a living entity, at that time the Haladini potency becomes manifest in the heart, and that's what attracts Krishna, this Haladini potency within the devotees. So God's business is pleasure. So the pleasure is the Haladini potency. That is why we always try to seek the mercy of Srimati Radharani. And Krishna tells, I think, Narad Muni or Uddhava, that I say unto you again and again and again and again that if you want my mercy, then you should get the mercy of Srimati Radharani, otherwise my mercy doesn't arise. So anyway, Krishna appears with his pastimes to enlighten the world and bring all the living entities back home, back to Godhead. That's his business of Krishna. Sometimes he brings his own place, Vrindavan, his own devotees, his mother Yasoda, Nanda Maharaj, the cowboys, Radharani and the gopis, cows, peacocks, everything, the river Jamuna, Govardhan, Radhakund. He displays all of this, all these wonderful pastimes. That is his mercy. And now we have something to talk about, something to hear about, something to chant about. If God just appeared here and then he left, that's nice. But when he comes, he leaves his pastimes, he performs the pastimes, leaves them behind them, they're recorded by different sages. So now we have something to talk about, now we have something to chant about, now we have something to serve about. So this is the mercy of Krishna. When he appears here or his devotees appear here, he gives us an opportunity to remember the eternal pastimes of the Lord. So there's a few appearances of Radharani. They're kind of majestic. Many stories we get from different Puranas. They're not exactly a Shukadeva Goswami was speaking it, because he was Shukadeva Goswami is a great Rashika, relisher of Krishna's pastimes. So yeah, so a lot of these things are not in Bhagavatam, because they're all kind of a majestic aspects of Radha and Krishna, but they're getting covered by their opulence, by the sweetness gets taken away, of the Vrindavan sweetness. So many, many stories in the Puranas, and they're dealing with Radha and the kind of majestic aspects. But Sukadeva Goswami didn't touch so much on that, but he spoke just the relationships in Vrindavan, the different emotions that they share in Vrindavan, because this is actually the original feature of a Godhead. Krishna in his Kishore age with Srimati Radharani, boy, girl, this is the original sex. Prabhupada said, where does it come from? It's in this material world. It comes from the spiritual world. Nothing can exist in the material world that's not in the spiritual world. So we find sex life is in the material world. Why? Because it's there in Goloka Vrindavan, in the spiritual world. Otherwise it wouldn't be that here or there. So this is called the Adi Rasa, or the original Rasa of Krishna, Krishna's greatest pleasure with his Srimati Radharani. So this is the original feature of Godhead, this conjugal relationship. And from this relationship, all the other relationships expand, like Vatsala Rasa, Shakya Rasa, Shantaras. They're all actually to assist the conjugal rasa of Krishna. This is the original feature of Godhead. So all these others, just like the Vatsala Ras, Radha and Krishna, the only thing they ever want is to be together. That's all they ever want. And this is actually the picture of Vrindavan. Everybody's working, united to bring Radha and Krishna together. And then after that, they're working to separate them again. And then again, they're working to unite them again. And through the different pastimes throughout the day, this is what's happening. Radha and Krishna meeting, a bit early morning, and they're separated. Then they come, they meet again at noontime. Krishna goes out with the cows, and Radha Kund, they meet again at Radha Kund. Then they have to be separated again, because they got to get home with the cows before it gets too dark and things like that. So separation is there. And again, in the night time, again, they are united by the different plans and programs from the different shakis, what pastimes we will have tonight. Where will the venue be? Where will... They're always discussing and then them sending messages where, how to meet where. So it's, they're bringing together. So this is the picture of Vrindavan. It's bringing Radha and Krishna together and then separating them again. In the material world, we would think that the union was better. So let's have union all the time, rather than separation. But in God's program, no. The separation is there. That enhances the union when there is separation. So, Hare Krishna. Yeah, so this is a picture of Vrindavan. So this constant variety, it's not just one thing. If I was God, I would just have everything nice and... Well, sometimes not nice things. By fate, the elderly persons are there, Jasoda and Nanda are there. How can Radha and Krishna be together? They're longing to be together. So the presence of Jasoda and Nanda there, they're enhancing the love in separation from Radha and Krishna. So like they're helping it. They're Vatsala Ras, they're seeing Krishna as their child, but they're assisting in the conjugal Ras by their being superiors there, and Krishna can't act freely like he does with Radharani when they're alone with their friends. So there was a song, if I rule the world, every day would be the first day of spring. So it'd be nice spring, everything is flowers, and okay, let's keep it like this forever. It's not like that, Krishna. Variety is the spice of life. Krishna has his summer season, spring season, and a rainy season. So there's always constantly changing. Rainy season, they will do different things. They go in the caves of Govardhan when it rains on, things like that. And so there's constant changing, constantly. It's not just one thing. This is, I guess the idea is Mayavad. Everything's the same. If we just pick the best of everything and we remain like this forever as God. No. We want to be together. No, God has separation also. Yeah, so this Krishna, Jugala, Kishore, this Krishna is the original feature of Godhead. It's very, very difficult to comprehend for scholars who are searching for the truth, the absolute truth, to come to a conclusion that God is a little cow boy looking after cows. Very difficult. So this is the original feature of Godhead. Generally when we find out, we're trying to find out the truth, we're seeking the truth, it's good to start at one point. That's how generally we want to make a reference from one. It must be one point, everything started from one point. We can't comprehend that it. So scientists, they're trying to find that one point. They have different theories about, you know, everything expanded from that one point. But we say, no, We say that God and these energies expanded simultaneously, manifested simultaneously, because God alone, it's not much meaning to God actually. If you, without his potencies, without his energy, it's not much meaning, just like the sunshine, if the heat and light of the sun, the energies of the light weren't present, then the sun would have no meaning. There'd be no light, there'd be darkness, there'd be no heat. So it has no meaning, God alone. So we say the original feature of God, it is God along with his energies that manifested along with his energies. Not that there was one Krishna at one point and then he manifested everything, although he's saying Aham Sarvasya Prabhavo, he did, everything is coming from me. But we Gaudiya like to understand that everything is manifested simultaneously. God along with his different energies. This is a complete picture of God. So there's one description of the appearance of Srimati Radharani. Today's her birthday, appearance Srimati Radharani ki chair. And Maharaj Vrishabhanu, he was taking his bath in the Jamuna, and then 1,000 petal lotus came floating down the Jamuna and touched the body of Maharaj Vrishabhanu. He was taking his bath in the Jamuna, meditating, and this lotus came, 1,000 petal lotus came and touched his body. So he opened his eyes and he saw it was a beautiful little girl in the whirl of the lotus, kicking her legs, like arms and legs, and like a little baby. So he immediately took, he was astonished by the beauty of the baby, so he immediately took, he didn't have any daughter. So he took her home and gave to Kirtita. Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtita, these are the original, eternal parents of Radharani. So Radharani just manifested herself through the lotus floating down on the Jamuna. There's also a description of Srimati Radharani created Mayapur. This is from the Namadip Dham Mahatmya. From the Pamankan, chapter 2. From the Ananta Samhita. Parvati said, O Lord, please directly describe exactly how and when Srimati Radharani created Navadvip. Lord Shiva replied, Parvati, please hear the reason for Navadvip's appearance, as described in Ananta Samhita, and as I heard from the mouth of Lord Narayana. As a bee plays on the lotus, Krishna was enjoying with Viraja in a pleasant forest grove in Vrindavan. The moon flies the doe-eyed Radhika heard this news from one Shakya and hastily ran to find Krishna. Seeing that Radha was coming, Krishna suddenly disappeared, and the Viraja River, Viraja Devi became a river. Radha again heard that Krishna was enjoying with Viraja, and he went. But when she arrived there, she could not find them. Absorbed in thoughts of Krishna, Radha began to think. She gathered her Shakyas together with, in between the Ganges and the Jamuna River. She created there a beautiful place. We're between the Ganges, or Ganges, okay. She created a beautiful place decorated with creepers and trees and filled with male and female bumblebees. Deers and bucks were happily engaged in enjoying as they wandered around. The whole area was filled with the fragrance of jasmine, mallika, and malati flowers. That transcendental abode was adorned with tulsi forests and decorated with various groves. On Radha's order, the Ganges and Jamuna, with their pleasant water banks, acted as a moat to protect the garden. Cupid himself, along with springtime, eternally reside there, and the birds constantly sing the auspicious name of Krishna. Radha, dressed in a colorful cloth, began to play a beautiful melody on a flute in order to attract Krishna. Attracted by the melody, Krishna appeared in that enchanting place. Radha, the attractor of Krishna's mind, seeing that Krishna had come, held his hand and experienced ecstatic delight. Then Krishna, understanding Krishna's mood, spoke in the voice, stroke of love. O lovely face Radha, you are my very life. There is no one more dear to me. Therefore, I will never leave you. Just for me, you have created this wonderful place. Staying with you here, I will transform this place, filling it with shakis and groves. The groves will be glorified. The devotees will glorify this place as new Vrindavan, Nava Vrindavan. At this place is like an island or deepa. Otherwise, others call it Nabadvip. Otherwise, shall call it Nabadvip. By my order, all the holy places here reside. Because you have created this place for my pleasure, I will live here eternally. Those devotees who come here and worship us will certainly obtain our eternal service in the mood of the Shakis. O dear Radha, like Vrindavan, this place is extremely pure. If anyone comes here just once, he will attain the results of going to all the sacred places. He will quickly attain devotional service, which satisfies us. Lord Shiva continued, O most fortunate Parvati, saying this, Krishna, the Lord of Radha, merged with Radha's body and began to reside there eternally. Seeing that Satchitananda form outwardly of a fair complexion, but inwardly Krishna himself, Lalita gave up her beautiful form for the service of Gauranga. She took on a male form to suitably receive the affection of Gauranga. Seeing that Lalita had taken such a form, Vishakha and all the other Shakis also suddenly took forms, male forms. At that time, a tumultuous vibration of Jai Gaudi filled the four directions. From that time, the devotees called this form of Krishna Gaur Hari. Just as Radha is Gauri, fair, and Krishna is Hari, when they combine in one form, they are called Gaur Hari. Since then, the lotus-eyed, flute-playing, threefold bending form of Krishna and the lotus-eyed form of Radha, Radhika Devi, remain there combined in one form. Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki, Gaur Hari ki. There's also a nice pastime of Radha and Krishna. It's called Swapna Bilash, dreaming pastime. So one day Radha woke up and she said, Krishna, I had just had an astonishing dream last night. And it was a beautiful place, just like Vrindavan. It was full of groves and trees, and there were birds and bees were humming. And there was a beautiful river, just like the Jamuna. And then there was this beautiful golden Brahmana boy, and with his associates, and they were performing Harinam Shankirtan. And sometimes this golden boy, he'd be going, Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna, and he would fall on the ground, just like I do that sometimes when I chant Krishna. I'm like that sometimes. And then other times, that golden boy was saying, Hey Radha, hey Radha, hey Radha, where is Radha? Or hey Radha. Just like you chanting like that. So, who was his personality? If it was me, then where were you? And if it was you, where was I? Because we're always together. Krishna said, a very, very mysterious dream. How am I expected to understand this deep mystery? Radha said, you know everything, Krishna. And because you are smiling now, I can understand who that person that is. It was you and it was me. It's both of us combined. What is the mystery of this form? Radha said, because you are smiling, and you must know the reason for this. So then Krishna's jewel. Krishna has a Kushtabha jewel. It's a, I've heard the description that it's like a jade stone. You know the jade? Semi-precious stone. Greenish color. Pale kind of green. And it has a calf engraved on it. I think Mahanidhi Maharaj gave that understanding. Anyway, Krishna always has his Kushtabha money. This distinguishes him from others. Srivatsa and Kushtabha money he has. These are Krishna's eternal ornaments. So that began to illuminate and get lighter and lighter, and it spread like rays. And Radharani was seeing that Kushtabha money manifesting. Then she saw, through those rays, she saw the pastime that she had at night, the dream. And she saw, that form of Gauranga. Sometimes in the mood of Krishna, sometimes in the mood of Radha. It became manifested from that Kushtabha money. So she said she was very happy to understand that, but she said another thing, I'm understanding from this Kushtabha money, I'm looking through the rays and I'm seeing my worshipful Lord who is Shyamasundar. Other person is looking at rays at the Kushtabha money, but he's seeing his worshipful object. So who is ever your worshipful deity, you can see it through that particular ray, although Krishna. She says, I can understand. Krishna is one and he becomes many. So Radharani said, this is it. Everybody's Ishtadeva, a worshipful deity, you can see it coming from that particular ray, from the Kushtabha money. It's like you look at the sun. We all look at the sun. Everybody's going to be seeing through different sun rays. You're going to have your own sun ray. You'll see the sun. So similarly, everyone who is, they have their worshipful deity, they can see that Krishna is one, but looking through the rays of Kushtabha Muni, they will see their worshipful Lord, maybe Ramachandra or Lakshmi Narayan or Radha and Krishna. So Radharani says, now I can understand that statement, that you are one, but you are many simultaneously. Śrīmatī Rādhārāṇī kī jaya. So Śrīmatī Rādhārāṇī is Prabhupāda said, the topmost mistress for Krishna's enjoyment. But she has always engaging in Krishna's service, she has, and especially cooking for Krishna. She had a boon from Devarsha Muni. I don't think it was the angry Devarsha Muni, it was another Muni. But he was very pleased with it. I think maybe she served him. And he was very pleased. And he said, I will give you a blessing that anything you cook will become just like nectar. So Radharani has that benediction. So Jasoda understood that Krishna has this special benediction, that whatever she cooks is like nectar. And I only want Krishna to have the best. He must have that nectar from Radharani's, because she's the best cook. So Radharani, you have to come to my house every day, and you have to cook for Krishna in my house. And she said, oh no, I can't go there, I'm a young girl. And Krishna is there, how can I go? And Shakya said, no, we'll come with you, don't worry, Jasoda, we'll take... She won't see Krishna even. She won't even see Krishna's shadow. We'll take great care of her. So like this, under the pretext of being there with Krishna, and she's feigning the fear anyway. So she goes with her shakis, so she's so happy, it's all she ever wants to do is serve Krishna and cook for Krishna. So they go to Jasoda's house. Jasoda has 50 stoves in her kitchen. So Radharani is cooking on all these different stoves, and all of her shakis are helping, and they're all cutting sabjis and grinding spices, and Radharani is running from one stove to another one. And the shakis are giving the spices, and she's so like this. Every day she cooks a great feast for Krishna, the chapon bhog. Bhaktivinoda Thakur sings in the Raj Bhog Arati song. Shukta shakhaya di baji nalita kushmando dalida na duta thambi dari mocha kanda mudga bara mashabara rotika kritana shashkuli pishtaka kira puli paya shana kapuro ramrita keli ramba kira shora amritara salayamla dwadasa pakar chau chatnis also. Luchi chini sharapori ladura shabali bogina karena Krishna hai kutahali. That's what she's cooking for Krishna every morning. This before he goes out with the cows, because he'll get hungry, the little boy, so he must have a big feast. So that is what is cooked. Bhaktivinoda Thakur calls it the Raj Bhog Artig song, because nobody can cook it for breakfast. Krishna takes it for breakfast. That's his breakfast. But we don't have enough time to cook chapon 56 items before breakfast. So he's called it the Bogartik song. At least about 12 o'clock we can get it together by 12 o'clock by cooking 56 items of nice preparations. So then Krishna relishes it. Prasadam cooked by Radha, and then we can get Krishna Prasadam. Krishna Prasadam ki jai. So this is the way it goes up through parampara. We offer the boga. There was one of the items in the 64 upacharas we're offering in deity worship is asan, the fifth number upachara from the 64 upacharas called asana. So I asked Srila Prabhupada, what is the meaning of this asana? And he said, yes, you have the picture of the guru is there, and you bring the asan. Asan means sitting place, mat. So you bring the asan, and he said, this asan is for the guru. And we offer the boga to the guru, and he offers to his guru. And then he will offer to his guru. And like that, it will be offered to Radha and then Krishna. He said, this is the system, parampara system. So this is the system. So ultimately, when we're offering the bhoga to Guru, he offers to his Guru. Then ultimately it's offered to Srimati Radharani and then Krishna. They're not eating it, they're passing it up. And so the so ultimately then for us it goes to Radha. For other devotees it will go to Lakshmi or Sita Radha. And they will offer to Ram, Lord Narayana, or Radharani will offer to Krishna. Then Krishna will happily accept that, eat it, then it will come back down parampara as Mahaprasad. Therefore Radharani is our guru, parampara guru. So Radharani, the tatvaya, haladini shakti, haladini potency, the pleasure giving potency. It's sometimes we hear of Bhakti Devi. The question often comes up, who is Bhakti Devi? Most people understand Radharani is Bhakti Devi. Or sometimes Tulsi, Vishnu Bhakti Preti Devi. So that is description of the Bhakti Devi. Because it's a combination of Haladini potency. So in that aspect then Radharani is Bhakti Devi. But this is from the Harinam Chintamani. This chapter is Development of Rasa. So then, by the great mercy of the Holy Name, a mixture of the Haladini and Sanvit Shaktis from the spiritual world combine as Bhakti Devi herself. So the Saladini, the pleasure-giving potency, and the Sambit. Sambit means conscious. We're aware. Consciousness. Oh, from that time, Sambit and Aladini descend from the spiritual world. They combined as Bhakti Devi herself. They descend on the small jiva, who possesses only a small portion of Haladini and Sambit energy. Bhakti Devi reveals to the jiva the ingredients of rasa in the full-blown flower of the Holy Name. By the mercy of the pure jiva, by her mercy, the pure jiva takes on his spiritual body and enters into the experience of rasa. It's also mentioned in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Anyway, it's saying the same thing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Anyway, I can't see it. But it says that in the same thing in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Also in Brahma Samhita. That the living entity, we want bhakti We want love of Krishna. But because of our minute size, we're not powerful enough to reach Krishna. We are Satchit Ananda, we're that Haladini, Sambit and Sandini potency. Their eternal potency is that the living entity is. That is the identity of the living entity. So when one becomes conscious of his real identity, or his real identity, and understands that he's the eternal servant of Krishna, and he wants to engage in service to receive the goal of devotional service, love of Godhead. But the jiva is not powerful enough to reach Krishna because of his minute size. But by his process of bhakti, sadhana bhakti, and his practicing sadhana bhakti, then he said, by the mercy of the holy name, or by the mercy of someone, guru or Krishna himself, that Krishna is recommended by your guardian angel or fairy godmother, guru, whoever it is, but someone may recommend, or Radharani may recommend to Krishna that he's performing very nice service, she's performing nice service, please be merciful. And Krishna, he will not refuse if Radharani recommends a person. So then at that time, because the achiever is too small to approach Krishna, at that time Krishna, he sends his Haladini potency and Sambit potency. He is unlimited, Ananda, unlimited consciousness. So at that time, the Krishna, he sends his Haladini potency and the Sambit potency to mix with the jiva. Then you become very attractive because the Haladini potency has increased. So that's what attracts Krishna. So Krishna is, wherever that service is, Haladini potency is acting, and Krishna is attracted there. So in this way, how we can attract Krishna through this process of bhakti yoga. So then Radharani herself becomes bhakti devi, the combination of the sambit and sambit and Haladini potency. Enters the heart, and then you become very attracted to Krishna. There is Haladini. He's looking. Where is Haladini? That means his pleasure. So then Krishna becomes very much attracted to that Haladini in the heart. Then you enter into your eternal relationship with Krishna. Hare Krishna. This is our goal, actually, of the devotees. We want to enter into that situation of service to Radha and Krishna, ultimately. Naham vrcho narapati na vaishana shudro naham parani na chatva kintu patan nikila paramanandaram gopi pariyakamalo das anudas. To become the servants of the servants of the servants of Gopi Padya Kamala Dasa, Gopinath, the master of the gopis. This is our identity given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He identified himself, I am servant and the servant of the servant of the master of the gopis. Master means Nath, and Gopi means Gopi, so Gopinath. Gopinath is our Ishtadeva for the followers of Gauranga Mahaprabhu and Krishna. So Mahaprabhu has given us our identity. So we belong in that atmosphere of bringing Radha and Krishna pleasure, that Haladini potency, that Haladini atmosphere. And Srila Prabhupada, he concludes in Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada's conclusion. Often the author of a book he reveals a conclusion at the end. Often they're like that, you get the conclusion. The Siddhanta comes at the end. So at the end of Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita, he is giving us the Siddhanta. The whole Bhagavad Gita. So this is from the 18th chapter, the last chapter. Last chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Text 73, the last shloka of Bhagavad Gita, the last purport of Bhagavad Gita, the last sentence or paragraph, last paragraph of Bhagavad Gita. Prabhupada is explaining that the living entity in his original position is pure spirit. He is just like the atomic particle of the Supreme Spirit. A conditioned entity, however, has a marginal energy of the Lord. He tends to be in contact with both the material energy and spiritual energy. In other words, the living entity is situated between the two energies of the Lord. And because he belongs to the superior energy of the Lord, he has a particle of independence. By a proper use of this independence, he comes under the direct order of Krishna and he attains his normal condition in the pleasure-giving potency. Halalini potency ki. So this is where Prabhupada's taken us. You attain your normal condition in the pleasure-giving potency. That means you go... All the pastimes are going on under this pleasure potency. So we go back to Godhead. We join that atmosphere of Halladini, where Krishna's pleasure is the only objective. And all of the activities there, all the services, Krishna's pleasure is the only objective. So we go back into that, and Prabhupada's, it's in English, but he finishes on this point, the last sentence. Thus he maintains his normal condition in the pleasure-giving potency. That's in the Bengali it says, Haladini potency. So this is where Prabhupada is taking us through Bhagavad Gita as it is, into that atmosphere of Haladini, where everything is, everyone and everything is being used for serving Krishna, Radha and Krishna. That's where Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita is taken. Everything's in my books, Prabhupada said. Prabhupada ki jai. So, we have some information of Srimati Radharani from the Radha Krishna Gadasa Deepika of Srila Rupa Goswami. This is a translation from Kushukrata Prabhu. And after describing Krishna's beauty and Krishna's birthday, then Rupa Goswami is describing the Radharani's qualities. Among all the beautiful gopis, Srimati Radharani is the best. Radharani is the queen of Vrindavan. She has many famous friends, headed by Lalita and Vishakha. Vishakha Devi ki jai. Vishakha Shakhi Arivab Mahotsab Titi ki jai. It's her birthday today also, Vishakha Devi. Srimati Radharani's rival is Chandravali. Among Chandravali's friends are Padma, Shama, Shaiva, Bhadra, Vichitra, Gopali, Polika, Chandra, Shalika, Mangala, and many more. The beautiful gopis may be considered in hundreds of groups. Each group contains hundreds and thousands of gopis. Variety is like the spice of life. So Krishna, there are different groups, different... So Krishna, he likes, like a bumblebee, goes from one flower, takes a little bit of nectar, goes to another. So Krishna's like that. So many different groups, different qualities, different pastimes. Yeah, hundreds and thousands. Among these gopis, the most important are Srimati Radharani, Chandravali, Bhadra, Shyamra, and Paulika. These gopis are full of all transcendental good qualities. So there are different descriptions of different shakis. And different descriptions. But when we say Asta Shaki, we're referring to Lalita Vishaka, Induleka, Rangadevi, Sridevi, Champaka, Chitradevi, and Tungabiji Devi. These are actually Radharani's intimate friends. They're also group leaders like Shyam and Paulika and Chandravali. They're leaders of groups. So Radharani's friends, Asta Shaki, they're also group leaders, but they choose to come and serve Srimata Radharani because they know by pleasing Radharani, Krishna's pleasure will be obtained. So they're considered the best. They're friends, intimate friends. But you often get descriptions of the main shakis, eight main shakis, but they're different kind of shakis. But these are the intimate friends. So they want to be intimate, friendly with Radharani. Then they'll easily get the mercy of Krishna. Now the beauty of Srimati Radharani's transcendental form will be described. Srimati Radharani is expert in fine arts, and her transcendental form is like an ocean of nectar. Her splendid bodily luster is like the yellow pigment, gorochana, molten gold, or stationary lightning. She wears wonderfully beautiful blue garments, and she is decorated with various pearls and flowers. She is very beautiful, and she has long, nice braided hair. She is decorated with a garland of flowers and a beautiful pearl necklace. Her splendid forehead is decorated with the red pigment sindur, with the beautiful locks of curling hair. So she has a spot here. It's called the Karma Yantra. The Karma Yantra. It's red kumkum they put, and eight chandan spots around it, and sometimes one kasturi spot there also. It's called the Karma Yantra. Everything is personified in the spiritual realm. So that is the personality who is Radharani's Karma Yantra. Decorated with blue bangles, her arms have defeated Cupid's staff with their beauty. Decorated with black mascara reaching back to her ears, Srimati Radharani's lotus eyes are most beautiful in the three planetary systems. Her nose is beautiful like a sesame flower, and it's nicely decorated with a pearl. Sesame flower. Sesame flower, you have to look from the top, look down onto the sesame flower. And it has a little, it's a very small flower, but it has kind of like nostrils. If you look down from that position, you get these little nostril flares. So the sesame seed flower is like that. If you look from the top, you can see like little nose rather than so. Krishna's nose is also described as like sesame seed, also flower. She is anointed with various perfumes. She is splendidly beautiful. Her ears are decorated with wonderful earrings, and her nectarian lips defeat the red lotus flowers. Her teeth are like rows of pearls, and her tongue is very beautiful. Decorated with nectarian smile of pure love for Krishna, her beautiful face is as splendid as a million moons. The beauty of her chin has defeated and bewildered the demigod Cupid. Decorated with a drop of musk, her chin appears like a golden lotus flower with a bumblebee. So her chin is like a flower, and she has black, was it? Musk, yeah, musk is a deep brown color. So she has a black, it looks blackish. It's a black spot. Her chin is like lotus. And the black spot is a bumblebee. Like a bumblebee. Bearing all the marks of wonderful beauty, her neck is adorned with the strings of pearls. Her neck, back and sides are enchantingly beautiful. Her beautiful breasts are like two splendid golden water pots, covered by a bodice and decorated with necklace of pearls. Her beautiful enchanting arms are decorated with jeweled armlets. Her arms are also decorated with jeweled bracelets and other kinds of jeweled ornaments. Her hands are like two red lotus flowers, illuminated by the series of moons that are her fingernails. What time are we supposed to finish? Huh? 7:30. Now? Okay. Okay. Shrimad Radharani Arivab Mahotsabhti Ki Jai. Radharani's appearance day Ki Jai. Mitai Go Premanandi. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Prabhupada Ki Jai. Sambhaita Bhakti Ki Jai.